This will be the IC555. Pin number 1. Here, first of all, we have to observe the notch. This will be the notch. This is pin number 1, 2, 3, 4. Then here we have 5, 6, 7, 8. So, like that, it is a 8 pin IC. First of all, to work this timer circuit in a unstable mode and which will generate the square waveform, you have to connect pin number 1 to the ground. Pin number 1 is grounded. Then pin number 5 is also grounded through this capacitor. Pin number 5 is nothing but our control voltage pin, which is grounded here. Now pin number 8 we have to connect to the supply. So pin number 8 is connected to the supply. Pin number 4 we have to also connect this to the supply. So pin number 4 we have to connect to the supply. Okay, so this will be the connection. Now we have to connect RA RB resistance. So first of all, RA resistance having value 1.5 kilo ohms is connected here. Then we have a RB resistance value, which is nothing but 6.2 kilo ohms, and here we have our capacitor. Okay, positive entering point and negative is grounded. So this will be the connection. Now pin number 2 is connected to this point between the capacitor and the resistance. Pin number 6 from this point is connected to this point. Actually pin number 2 and 6 get connected together. Pin number 2 is nothing but the trigger. Pin number 6 is threshold, and the pin number 7 is connected to this point. This is the discharge pin. So your circuit is complete. Now apply the input. Sorry, for a multivibrator there will be no input. Just connect the supply, which is nothing but the 5 volts. So 5 volt supply you have to connect here. So this will be the positive terminal of a supply. This will be the negative terminal. Yes, now it will generate the square waveforms. If you wanted to observe the output, then connect the LED at pin number 3 and you will observe the on off action of a LED. It represents a square waveform having T on period and T off period. You may also change the capacitance value to get different frequencies at the output. Here you will observe that LED is on. It means that the frequency of the output waveform is much more larger one. So to observe that frequencies, okay, we have to use oscilloscope. Remove this LED. Okay, connect here oscilloscope or DSO. So DSO out pin is connected here. Now on DSO you will observe this waveform. So this is nothing but your on off action. If you wanted to observe the capacitor charging and discharging time period, just use the second channel of a DSO. Okay, here ground is connected, and across capacitor we have to connect the connection. So when you do it, when you press the auto button, here you will observe the charging and discharging cycle. So when you adjust it, here you will observe that during the charging period, yes, during the charging period of a capacitor, the T on period will be there. You will have a high output. During the discharge period, you have a low output. So capacitor start charging and discharging. During charging, it will charge
through this RA and RB resistance, and during discharging it will discharge through this RB resistance only. So that's why you have a waveforms like this. One can adjust this T on period and T off period by adjusting the values of resistances and capacitors. So that means RA, RB and capacitor value. So this will be nothing but the 2/3 of the VCC value, and this is nothing but the 1/3 of the VCC value. So this experiment represents a stable multivibrator where both the states are unstable, and you will have a square waveform or a rectangular waveform at the output. You may also connect a diode across the RB resistance so that you will get a 50% duty cycle. Okay, because of that it will generate a duty cycle. You have to measure the on period, off period, and calculate the on period and off period, and you have to tally it. This is nothing but our experiment number or experiment which represents operation of a IC555 timer as a stable multivibrator. Thank you.